called for interview at different TCS offices across India depending on their college and city. I will share one very interesting experience of students facing interviews last time. Some students faced 2 interviews and got selected. Some students faced 3 interviews and got selected in TCS. And surprisingly, some students faced just 1 interview and were still selected for TCS. So TCS has some internal selection strategies based on which they decide whether to select the candidate, reject the candidate, or send him for the next interview. But generally speaking, 3 different interviews are conducted by TCS, which are technical interview, management interview, and personal or HR interview. Now let us discuss in brief what they ask in each of these interview rounds. First, technical interview. In technical interview, they want to check your programming and coding skills. Basic C programming knowledge is must for all students, including non-CSIT students. And they will expect knowledge of object-oriented language also from CSIT students. They will check also your IT awareness and knowledge about latest technologies. Now, what are the ways interviewer will check the above knowledge? And what should be the preparation strategy for technical interview? We know that interviewer can ask 2 types of questions. First, new or surprising questions, or the questions from his own mind. Second, resume-based questions. Now, for the first type, they might ask questions regarding programming concepts. They might ask you to write a code. They can ask you simple programming logics or concepts related to database and data structure. I am going to share all the previously asked TCS technical questions with you later. Currently, I will not waste time in discussing questions, but we'll talk more about the strategy. Also, all of you know that TCS NQT was conducted all over India and students from different states, cities and regions have cracked the first round. Different students from different cities and colleges will be called for interviews at different locations across India. So obviously, the interview panel or the officials taking the interview for every student will largely differ. And hence, the technical questions asked will be mostly based on the interviewer's domain or his comfort zone. And hence, different students will get questions on different subjects or programming languages. But the most important thing, that is second type of questions or resume-based questions, are the ones which we can prepare with perfection. Now, what are the major parts of resume on which the technical questions can be asked? They are, first, academic projects. Second, extra or hobby projects which you have done. Third, final year project. Even if your final year project is not ready or if the idea is not clear, you need to give a rough idea. Internships and trainings, workshops, technical seminars and paper presentations, any online courses if you have done, coding competitions, hackathons which you have participated. Now, there is a concept called leading the interview. What is leading the interview? It is a trick by which you can make the interviewer ask questions you want. Now, that is something interesting, right? So how you can do it? Let's take a simple example. Interviewer asks you, tell me something about your mini project. Now your job is to be ready for the answer to this question and design the answer in such a way that you will end the answer on a concept or point on which you want the interviewer to ask the next question. Generally, a person remembers only the last few words of your answer during an interview. So you need to design the answer in such a way that the end point should be the one on which you want the next question to be. Now, when the interviewer asks you a question on that end point, you need to be ready with the answer which will again end with another point or concept of your choice. This is called leading the interview. You are making the interviewer ask questions which you want. But remember, this can only happen if you study properly and design the answer for the questions which can be asked based on the content of your resume. So I will recommend you to plan answers for all the major points in the resume which we discussed earlier, like academic projects, extra or hobby projects, final year project, internships and trainings, workshops, online courses if you have done any, technical seminars and paper presentations, also the coding competitions or hackathons which you have participated. Be ready with the answer for any of these points. One of the most important points is you should be able to give at least a small piece of information on all the workshops, competitions, seminars which you participate and the experience you had during that particular event, competition or workshop. Now, the second round is the management interview, which is basically the combination of technical and personal interview with a motive or intention to check your team skills, time management skills and confidence along with your presence of mind. Generally, the questions to check these skills are again based on your project or events and competitions which you have participated. Sometimes even situational based questions are also asked in this round. Again, as I previously mentioned, it is not necessary that everyone will face this interview round. The last is the personal interview round. It is as important as the technical interview. It is majorly conducted to check the future plans, work ethics, willingness to work in any location or shift, and your grooming or dress code and attitude. Some of the important personal interview questions are: tell me about yourself. What do you know about TCS? What are your areas of interest? What are your strengths and weaknesses? Are you ready to work anywhere in India? Where do you see yourself in next 5 years? Are you willing to work in different shifts? Why you want to join TCS? Are you planning for post-graduation? Challenging moment from your life? Sharing the best moment of your life? They will ask about your family background. They can even ask questions like, why should we select you? They can ask at the end of the interview, do you have any questions? They can even ask some tricky questions like, what will you do if we don't select you? Make sure you plan answers for all these questions very properly. One very important point, a well-designed resume with proper content will help you to get more questions based on your resume. And it is always better to